Okay. In Shechnar Hilchis Purim, Hilchis Megillah, the way it's called Shechnar Hilchis, the very, very last halachas in Shechnar Hilchis, and it starts from Simin Tav Reish, to be precise, I would say Pei, all the way until Tav Reish Tzadik Zayin. So there's a range of halachas that involve Purim, and my time limit is just a bit over an hour. So we're not going to cover everything, but we're going to cover some of the basic halachas that we need to know for ourselves, or benegatim iftzayim. Bichlalus, there's four key mitzvahs which involve Purim, and it's an easy way to remember. They all start with the letter Mem. The Rebbe once spoke about the significance of the fact that it starts with the letter Mem, and Mem Pesuch represents Golus, and Purim is etik m'hapach Golus. We're not going to go down that right now, but if you want, you can look it up in the Sicha, in Tavshim Mem Tes, Sefer HaSichas Mem Tes. The four mitzvahs are Mikra Megillah. All of them listed in the Megillah. Mikra Megillah, Mishloach Manus, Matanus Leizayinim, and Mishter Simcha. Of course, there's the natural stuff that we do throughout the day. When we daven, we add Alanissim, but that's not one of the mitzvahs of the day. That's like we have Halacha we're supposed to mention. Me'ein Hamu'ura, B'chol Yom V'yom, Ten Leim En Berchoysa, we learn it from a Pasuk. We're supposed to mention the day when it comes to the day. Chanukah, Purim, Shabbos, Rosh Chodesh, Yom Tov, etc. If this is a bit difficult to remember, if you want to add a fifth mem, we could add the word malacha. There's the isra of malacha. I would really put that under the category of mishtav simcha, which is the type of yomtiv that it is. So we're just going to try to go through al aseidah, the various different halachas, in things that are negei lemaisa. By way of introduction, Purim is in some ways more chamra than many other mitzvahs, more serious. It's what's called midivrei kabbalah, at least according to some poskim. Midivrei Kabbalah, we have Deraisa, we have Drabanan. Divrei Kabbalah is something there in the middle. Divrei Kabbalah means something which is in the Nevi'im, because all the mitzvahs of Purim are found in the Sefer Megillas Esther. So it's much more than a regular Drabanan, and that could have some bearing on a bunch of different halachas. I'll give you right away an example, a case in point. The halacha is that a bar mitzvah b'achor min haTorah is not really considered a bar mitzvah. He's not chayav a mitzvah when he turns 13 in a Torah, necessarily. Because we need to check him out to see if he has signs of maturity, shtei sayers. But we have a halacha called chazaka de rava. Chazaka de rava means that the klal of rava, he coined this klal, so it's named after him. That chazaka is that if a kid is 13, mistama, he also has the natural signs of maturity. And therefore he's chayav to do mitzvahs. Chazaka is a klal and kolot to the kula. But Chazaka de Rava does not help when it comes to a mitzvah de Raisa, that he should be able to be mitzvah someone else. So if you have a child who's bar mitzvah, 13 years old, you want him to go to the Amid? No problem. You want him to lane? Also no problem. You want him to do something which is a mitzvah de Raisa and other people should be yotzeh based on that, to write a pair of film? Lav Dafki could do that. Okay. Parshas Zachar is talking something that people are moir. Let's not go into it, but in Alter Rebbe's mashmah that he's not worried about it. In Alter Rebbe, in Hilchis Kri Tachayim Hilch Shabbos. So, whatever. But some people talk and say that Rabbi Mitzvah Bachar should not lame Parshas Zachar, yes, like you're saying. Now let's go to Kriyas HaMegillah. Kriyas HaMegillah, arguably, you can say that if it's Midivrei Kabbalah, more than a regular Derabbanan, then maybe a Bar Mitzvah boy shouldn't be laying the Megillah. And indeed, there are many places that make a distinction. There's a Noid Behuda, Binyan Shleim. I don't want to go down the whole entire drasha right now. A lot of places can make a distinction between the night Megillah and the day Megillah. There's two Chiyuvim. That in the Megillah, it only says once to lay in the Megillah. It doesn't say you have to lay in it twice. And there's Rais from the Rishonim, there's Sichas from the Rebbe, like this, like that. Again, let's leave that for right now. But the argument is that by night is Midrabanan, and by day is Midivrei Kabbalah. And therefore, a Bar Mitzvah boy who practiced the Megillah, and he wants to lay in once in shul, when should we give him to lay in the Megillah? By night. By day, we'd rather not give him to lay in the Megillah, because could be he cannot be mitzi, unless we know he has signs of maturity. If he's nesmal, he's gone, if he has a full beard, then we could trust he's ready for sure about mitzvah. But the average 13-year-old does not have a full beard. You could get him checked out, but that's not so pleasant. So, what do you do on Miftzayim? Obviously, it's better that he should go on Miftzayim and lay in the Megillah for people than the person shouldn't hear Megillah at all. Because A, could be Megillah is not Divrei Kabbalah. Could be even if it's Divrei Kabbalah, you could have a Bar Mitzvah boy. Could be this Bar Mitzvah boy is really considered a gadol. We have so many different possibilities there. So if you have a guy in the nursing home who's definitely not going to hear the Megillah unless my mitzvah boy comes, I'm sure you should get my mitzvah boy to read. However, if you have two people going with time together, you have the older one and the younger one. So the older one should learn the Megillah by day. By night, it doesn't really matter. And just that's one example out of many examples where there's this shaila of Megillah having a stronger severity because it is Divrei Kabbalah. So now that we appreciate that, we have to understand when it comes to the mitzvahs of the day, we can't just treat them lightly. I'll give you another example. Avelus on Purim. It's a big machlokes if it is Avelus on Purim. The Mechaber of Shulchan Aruch himself contradicts himself between the Rechaim and Yerideh. In one place he writes one way, in one place he writes another way. The argument why there shouldn't be Avelus on Purim is that Purim is, Simcha be Purim is Divrei Kabbalah. Tzachiv me Divrei Kabbalah. And Avelus is Midrabanan. Well, not for the first day. So therefore the mitzvah Simchas Purim should outweigh Avelus. Again, that's just an example where Divrei Kabbalah plays an important role. So let's go through Allah Seder of the mitzvah of the day. I'm holding in front of me the booklet with the halachas of Purim. I'm just using this as a guide. It doesn't necessarily mean that I'm going to be saying everything that it says over here. Oh, what it says here altogether. It just helps me just stay focused. I see the backstory of the halachas of Seder. So, going through Allah Seder with the halachas. The time for Kriyas HaMegillah by night is L'chatchila from Tzeis HaKachavim, nightfall. Again, we go through this Mifzayim topic, question. It's late, they're changing the clock this Matzah Shabbos. You want to go Mifzayim, you go into a nursing home, it's too late to go to a nursing home to start laying the Megillah then, or to a hospital, to anything like that. So again, here we have to play this what's going to happen if you don't go, they're not going to have Megillah at all. So there's definitely a makom to start learning from Shkia. We're talking about the Rabbanan. By night it's for sure the Rabbanan. Or more or less. So if it's the Rabbanan, we can already be make or start learning from Shkia, because it's a Suffolk day, Suffolk night. There are poskim that say you light a lane already from Plag HaMincha. L'chatchila, we don't rely on that. Mamash, Shas, Achad, Godl. There's a minority opinion that says you can lane that. No, you can't move to Tzayim. You might as well hear from Plag HaMincha, otherwise you won't hear at all. That's understandable. But otherwise, you really have to wait till Tzeis HaKachavim. After the fast is officially over by Tzeis, by Nesester. However, you're not supposed to eat before Kriyas HaMegillah. And really, you're not supposed to eat before Kriyas HaMegillah by day also. And the place can actually ask the question, why is this more serious than any other mitzvah that was so makbah not to put anything in our mouth? Derechlal, before mitzvah, you're not allowed to eat, but you're allowed to put something in your mouth. What we call Te'ima Ba'alma. Te'ima normally means not a suda. The definition of a suda is if you're eating a kebeah of bread or cake or drinking alcoholic beverages. But if you're just having a snack, not cake or bread, or even if it's cake, less than the kebeah, you're having some fruits, there's no problem. So why can't a guy after the fast at least have a coffee? The coffee is actually the example mentioned in the Poskim. In those days they also had coffee. So a Poskim asked, and how's it different than Maidev every night? Look, there's coffee right there right now. Some people didn't have Maidev. Mitzvah says the Dreis of Krishna. That's a good question to understand why it's different. A lot of different explanations are given. The most simple, easy understood explanation is, if you were fasting all day long, and you tell the guy you could have a coffee, it's not going to stop at the coffee. That's the pashta answer. We made them, which makes an afkamina for those who weren't fasting, or for someone who lives in Yerushalayim who wasn't fasting either, because Taina Sesta is not Erev Purim, or for the Megillah in the morning, which you're also not fasting. So Megillah in the morning, there's more room, also Chetchili shouldn't do Te'ima, but there's more room to be lenient with Te'ima Ba'alma, with a Bais, Tzah, and Davening, for those who are allowed to eat before Davening, because it helps their Kavana by day. But by night, we talk, don't eat anything till after Kriyas HaMegillah. Now, till when could you learn the Megillah? Till Alei HaShachar. Some Lubavitcher Chassidim always like to do things the last minute, not that there's a source in Halacha for this. In Halacha, we have something called Zrizim Akdim Ulamitzvahs, but it could happen. Somebody, for whatever reason, didn't hand in the Megillah. It's unlike Krishma every single night. Maidev, Krishma at least. Some place in Molch Manasseh, you're supposed to say before Chatzos. And I know in 770 you can find me in Yonim at 3 o'clock in the morning, but you're really supposed to say Shema. At least without the Birchers Krishma, Shema before midnight. It's a first Mishnah, Meseches Brachas, every little kid knows. But by Kriyas HaMegillah, there is no such halacha other than Zrizim Akdim Ulamitzvahs. And 12 o'clock right now, we're going to change the clock, so it's going to be 1:05, let's say, Chatzos, approximately 1:06. So it's 1 o'clock, you know what I'm saying? Let's do it before 106. Okay, I'll do it after 106, it's fine. We'll have it set up more properly. Not that you're supposed to talk about a mitzvah, but you're doing it for a good reason. The Megillah by day, you could start laying the Megillah from Beit Sachama. I don't know when that is on Purim, anybody know? I think it's 7 something. Huh? Doesn't look like we have any Nets people over here in this room. Berach, yeah, 7 something, 7:15. Okay. So you can start all mitzvahs of the day. You start, you'll be the Eved, you could do it from Alois, but you have to wait till Netzachama. For those who are running to do an early mitzvah in the morning, till when could you lay in the Megillah? Until Shkia. Again, you're not supposed to push off a mitzvah, but you could do it until Shkia. What about Bein HaShemashis? So, Bein HaShemashis is a safek if you yotze the mitzvah. Especially remember what we said before, that Megillah might be Medivrei Kabbalah, by day especially, so you shouldn't run into what we call the safek zone after Shkia. But if a person didn't hear Megillah, and it's now 4 minutes before Shkia, she says, start reading the Megillah. He's not going to make a bracha because he's not going to finish the Megillah in 4 minutes. He has to finish the entire thing before Shkia to be able to make a bracha and to be able to be yoitza properly. But if you know, otherwise he's not going to hear the Megillah, so lay in after Shkia also. Till Sesek Chavim without a bracha. All these cases of times of Megillah apply to people who don't come to Shul. Al Pidin, you're supposed to come to Shul for Kriyas Megillah. You're supposed to lay in the Megillah Ba'asara. Even Kriyas Megillah Bizmana, when Imam is laying on the day, there's Shalei Bizmana, people are laying other days, which is not a day for us. But even Bizmana, you're supposed to do it Ba'asara Al Pidin. And not only you're supposed to do Ba'asara, there's a mitzvah called Berev Am, which is brought especially B'negeya too. Mikra Megillah, the whole sugi Masechus Megillah, Mevatel, the Kohen Mevatel, the Avoda, Levi Mevatel, what they're doing. Everybody's coming to hear Mikra Megillah, to hear it, according to many Mefarshim of the Gemara. Not the Kedah Megillah, they can do their own Megillah, they want to hear it, Berev Am. And the Poskim say that if you have a bigger shul and a smaller shul, you're supposed to hear the Megillah in a bigger shul. That doesn't mean you should be Mevatel, your minin kavua. If you have your shul is the smaller shul in town, there's another shul, is a bigger shul in town, you shouldn't be mevatel the minyan kavua in your shul. But a lot of shuls, they have to say that, you know, a lot of these big shuls, Al Derech 770, which you have a lot of side minyanim in all the side rooms. So to say that when it comes to Purim, then mevatel all the side minyanim. Because everybody should do, but Ivan. 770, Al Kapanim, in the time of the main minyan, they try to be mevatel all the other minyanim. But it's a mitzvah, but Ivan, rather than hearing the Megillah, okay, of course you're allowed to be here to make a lot at home. But actually, B'negei to Megillah specifically, it's brought that in of B'revam. Women and children are also chai B'kriyas HaMegillah, once children are the age of chinuch, which is a very difficult mitzvah to be the age of chinuch, to be able to listen to someone else talking for 20 minutes straight. Even adults have a hard time listening to someone else. But once a kid is able to, the age of chinuch is two things, side that he understands the mitzvah, but side that he actually could be mekayim the mitzvah. It's practically very difficult for kids to be mekayim the mitzvah. So if they're the age that actually could do that, you could train them in advance, you could talk to them about it. Certainly you shouldn't bring kids to shul that are going to disturb other people from hearing the Megillah, and that there's a very difficult age to know exactly what the borderline is. Because in Shulchan Aruch it says, Mechanchem es haktanim, it's a minig, it says, a minig that we used to bring ketanim to hear Megillah. So the person asked, what means a minig? It's a chiv of chinuch. So one of the explanations is, the minig is to bring even those that are lo yigil chinuch. The chiyuv is, that's one. Another answer is the minig is to bring them to shul and not to rely on them hearing the Megillah at home. The minig is they should also be part of the b'roiv am. It's another answer. But according to one answer, the minig was to bring even kids that are lower age. But you have to find that right age. Because if they're too young, then they disturb Kriyas HaMegillah. So we're talking about a bit older than the age where they disturb Kriyas HaMegillah. They could sit calmly, but they're not yet of age to be able to listen. That's not all kids even have that middle age. Some of them skip straight into the age of the Gila Chinuch. But if they're such kind of kids, and that's, by the way, one of the reasons why we say the four psukim loud, that the kids shouldn't fall asleep. You want to keep the kids, you want to have a monotonous thing, straight, the whole Megillah straight, just reading. So we have a few minhagim lach, ishiyudi, they wait for something special for the ishiyudi, and of course we have the haman, that keeps them busy also. For Chabad Chassidim, it's not that busy, it's only ones with a title, but it keeps them a bit, maybe it keeps also busy, it's one has a title, one doesn't, that maybe keeps them busy too. When it gets to the brachas on the Megillah, the Rebbe's meaning was the Rebbe himself made a bracha on the Kriyas HaMegillah. You could pashut see the Rebbe made a bracha on the Kriyas HaMegillah. But you always have to be careful whether it's smart to copy the Rebbe's Menhaga. I'm not going to the sugya of Hilchas and Kashas, which is a very difficult sugya. I haven't developed my Hiskashas enough level to know exactly when you're supposed to copy, not copy. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about the halacha right now. So people often copy the Rebbe. They have no idea what they're copying. First of all, they don't know what they see. Assuming that they know what they see, we'll have to know when they should copy that. So I'll give you an example which I've used in the past. Unfortunately, it's a true example. I know someone who was a chashvi, hata chashvi, and he was sitting shiva, and he didn't rip his jacket. Sim shiva after a parent. And he said, I'm chas the Rebbe didn't rip his jacket. It's taka true, but the Rebbe sitting shiva for his wife. And halach is, for a wife, one doesn't have to rip their jacket. Only their shirt. For a parent, they do have to. That's it. Straightforward in the Shulchan Aruch. But if a person doesn't know Shulchan Aruch and all he knows is Hilchis is Kash or something. The Rebbe didn't do it, the Rebbe is... Chafei the Rebbe did, obviously. But he wasn't around Chafei. So the Rebbe made a bracha in Kriyas HaMegillah, his own bracha. The Yisoid Yashayr Shavayri brings already such a name to make your own bracha. But the Rebbe also read the Megillah along the whole entire Megillah of the Balkaria. So now the person is going to say, okay, so I'll do the same also. The Rebbe knew that he's going to read the Megillah, he's not going to make any mistakes. Because if you make a mistake which changes the meaning of the word, then you're not Yotze Kriyas HaMegillah. So there's really no advantage in you reading from Megillah and you have a Baal Keira who actually knows the words. Well, let's hope the Baal Keira knows the words correctly. And you're going to read Bahama Nafal and say Bahama Nafal, you just kill the whole Megillah. Besides for the fact that if you're reading from Megillah, you should be careful that you don't disturb other people who are going to hear you and not hear the Baal Keira. The Rebbe was in his place, loud after other people would hear him. So again, you have to put things in. It's always good to have your own kashrut Megillah there. And the advantage of that is, even a chumash for that matter, sometimes for some people it's advantageous to have a kashrut Megillah, and for some people it's advantageous not to have a chumash. The nafkamin is if you know Kriyas HaMegillah or not. If you don't know Kriyas HaMegillah, it's very good to have a chumash. There's no mile in you having a Megillah. And what are you going to do with your chumash? First of all, you'll follow along. The halacha is that if you missed that one word, you're not yetzah. If your mind goes off and starts thinking about someone else, do you know someone that actually during Kriyas HaMegillah from Vayehi until the Chalzari, his mind does not think about someone else? You know such a person? Hard to find such kind of people. So there's a kula that my grandfather brings in his sefer, which makes a lot of sense, that if you're actually following along, that doesn't matter if your mind is somewhere else. Because that means you're actually hearing. But if you're not following along, you're hearing or you're not hearing. Even when you get to Kiddush Friday night, okay? Kiddush Friday night is not as long as Kriyas HaMegillah. But it's called the Bracha Arucha. It starts from the Gemara. The Gemara says about Malchi, Zechreinus, and Shofars. Why does everybody have to say themselves Malchi, Zechreinus, and Shofars, not listen to the Chazan? Because they're long brachas. And you might not pay attention. The Alter Rebbe brings when you get to Kiddush Friday night. It's a long bracha. You should say word for word along with the person saying Kiddush. The meaning is Beferish, not like that. People don't say word for the person saying Kiddush. Maybe the Alter Rebbe was talking about that he's mashman Alter Rebbe because the person doesn't understand the language. So if you don't understand, you could say another answer. Depends if you're looking from a city or not. No. Abdullah is not so long as Kiddush. Us, it's two separate brachas. It could be the same sort applies to Abdullah. But a person understands Hebrew, it's a whole different story. Then you can pay attention. But if you're looking from a siddur and you're following along, chances are that you're hearing what the person is saying. But you're standing by Kiddush and you're looking around the room and this kid is starting to schlep them on the skirt and this kid is starting to not touch the candles. Whatever, you're already distracted somewhere else. There's a major advantage in following along from a siddur. So that's one advantage in having a Megillah, even a Chumash Megillah, I'm talking about following along. The other plus of following along from a Chumash or Megillah is if you missed out some words, could happen. The person can miss out some words. Either because the kids are making noise, and there's a lot of times the noon of the Haman, you know, gets chopped off. And it's not the noon, there's some Balkaris that have a knack for this. They know how to swallow the end of the words. Kachushnu. So you can miss out words. Either the end or the whole word, or sometimes. So the halacha of the Megillah, you don't have to say the entire Megillah from Mitzvah Chaksav. As long as most of it was read, Mitzvah Chaksav, from the Kosher Megillah, Yoytza. Minority of it could be read Baal Peh. what if it's half and Pesach can talk about what if it's half and half. If you heard half of Megillah and half not. The famous Velt Kasha, the Megillah is an odd number of words. Whatever. I don't know. I don't know what the shot is why the Pesach can ask this question. What happens if it's half and half? But this brought such a discussion of Pesach. If it's half and half, could be still not yet. I don't know what that means. I mean, there's a Pashto answer. The Megillah, if the Megillah is written by Yevanis, because it could be, it's right, the Megillah by Yevanis, it ends up being, it could be, it's an even number of words. Who knows? So, Nachzalini Neidi, you're allowed to read, if it's up to half, you're allowed to read Baal Peh. Which is why also Megillah, which is, it's very hard to find a Pasul in Megillah. A word is missing in the Megillah, big deal. The Megillah is not going to be Pasul. The exceptions to that rule are, if it's the beginning of the Megillah, if it's the end of the Megillah, or if it's an Inyan Shalim, missing out a whole Kansi Geschichte, which according to some Paiskim, a set is B'nai Haman is an Inyan Shalim. It's one big Inyan. But if it's not an Inyan Shalim, okay, you missed out on some Pasuk, no problem. Take your Chumash. Nah, don't get a Megillah, no, your Chumash. Your Chumash, read it from the Chumash and catch up to the Baal Keira. You know, something that's sitting with the Baal Keira is reading fast, and you're a slow reader, and where were you? I have a minig. I read Megillah for my mother, and she had to say that it's like this. Whenever she thinks I'm ahead of, she doesn't know where I'm up to, she just gives a knock like that. That's an indication. I stop, wait, pause, and she catches up till where I'm up to. From where? From the Chumash. So as long as it's not, if you're reading very fast, the guy might miss Ganze Brocken. That's a whole different story. It might be an Indian Shalom. So, now, if you know the text of Megillah, you know the words, because it could be a difference of Mila El, Mila Ra, Nofal, Noifil, Yoshev, Yoshav. There's so many words. Shoyder, Shoyder. You don't know what you're doing. Read from a Chumash. If you know what you're doing, okay, that's an advantage. That's Megillah Kshayda. That's fine. That's perfectly legit. Some people have to use hearing aids. And hearing aids could be a shaila if a person is Yotze Megillah. Most hearing aids that come with batteries, talk could be a problem, because you're hearing it through a machine, and you're not hearing it the same like hearing through the phone. There were Peskim that allowed these things, but the Rebbe writes that all the Peskim that allow these things, Pasha did not understand the mechanism of a phone. The Rebbe gives an example. I don't know why this letter was printed in so many places, and each one of them chopped it up, so they're missing out the whole flow of the letter. This part that Rebbe actually writes in the letter, that part I found in one of the places this letter was printed. It ever since it's like listening to a recording of the Megillah. Not a live recording, I'm talking about to a tape recorder and listening afterwards. The same exact thing as listening on the phone. Listening on the phone, listening to a mic, listening to a radio, and listening with a hearing aid, which has a battery in it, is the same exact thing. So what's the eitz of a person that has a hearing aid? One eitz is you should stand in the balkoda. Take off his hearing aid and stand in the balkoda. The other eitz is let him hear the Megillah be yichidus. So he doesn't have to push and shul near the Balkaira, and he'll stand right next to the Balkaira. And if he can't hear without that, so then he has a thing called a Cheresh, which could be his Bechlal part from Kriyas Megillah, or he could read himself. Whatever, that's something that's such a shayla to talk to her. Ladies are not supposed to read the Megillah. I know today's day and age people are looking dafka to change the Torah and make women to be like men and men like women. So I have this thing that women are allowed to hear the Megillah. The Magen Avraham already brings from the Zohar that a woman is not supposed to read the Megillah. Then this, besides the Zohar in Yonam, there's also issues al-Pi Halacha. There was a minig in five communities that whenever you read for women, they didn't make a bracha. And the reason they didn't make a bracha was because the woman didn't listen to the whole thing.
What?
The woman didn't listen to the whole thing. There was no such thing as a woman listening to the Megillah. So you're not going to make a bracha. Bracha batala. They're not going to listen. So our women are Baruch Hashem educated, and some of them technically listen to the whole Megillah, but it's still totally not acceptable that a woman should read the Megillah. Of course, if a lady knows the Torah, and there's no one else to lay for her, and it's 20 minutes before Shkia, yes, she should lay in the Megillah. She's Yotze, Kriyas Megillah like that. But to say that is that a man is supposed to be laying the Megillah, especially if the reason why people want women to wear laying the Megillah is to show that women are like men, that it's not only a shayla of Mitzvah Drabbanon or Divrei Kavod Kriyas Megillah, it's a shayla of the Raisa of undermining the entire Torah. That's quite a serious issue. Something called in Halacha, La'itzim Liban Shal Tzedukim, we just finished all of this Pada Aduma. That's basically what it's full about. See, that somebody's doing some dafka to show against Torah, that's quite a serious problem. Talking during Megillah. You like to talk during Kriyas Megillah? What do you think?
No,
Russia. Somebody spoke during Krisa Megillah? So there's a misconception. People think if somebody spoke during Krisa Megillah, he's not Yotze. You're not allowed to talk during Krisa Megillah. Depends. If the person spoke during Megillah's Dvarim reading the Megillah, he was Yotze. He made a hefsek, which you're not allowed to do, but he was Yotze. If you're the one hearing the Megillah, you're not Yotze for a simple reason. Not because he spoke. Because when he's speaking, you can't hear what he's saying.
What's the made a break?
If Bal Kodah made a break, so it's taka isha of a hefsek, you're not supposed to talk.
But
no, let's say the Bal Kodah stopped, and someone else is talking during Megillah, which he's not allowed to. You have often people, Chabad House is a Chabad House on East Parkway between Kingston and Brooklyn. It's a big, massive Chabad House. And when it comes to Haman, some people start making all kind of strange noises because B'chal is a klal. There are certain noises that are not considered talking. Bum, 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 bum. Almost every single thing in the alphabet, in the alphabet, is already not together talking. So, and then you have some people go and stand there. Schweigschein. So, he's not allowed to do that. I'm not saying he's allowed to do that. But if he did talk, if he didn't miss out any words, he's Yotze Krisa Megillah. Not only is Yotze Krisa Megillah, but according to many poskim, as is mashmas takid halacha, you're allowed to even talk lechatchila if it's in Yonei Shal Yom. Guy's going to stand in the middle of Krisa Megillah and he's going to explain the Megillah. No problem. There was a minig in certain circles, in Munkach, and maybe other circles. So when it came to Vayislu, it sounds a beautiful minig. Let's not introduce him in 770. In Vayisla, somebody starts singing again. Ta da 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 da, ta da 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 da, ta da 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 da. Exciting niggin. And not only that, the Minchas Elazar would say quietly, "B'shas Ma'isa, Kein Yovdu Kalei Vecha Hashem." Now that's not a hefsek with Sinyon Eshel Yom. He's talking about Kriyas HaMegillah. Do you know the Behuda Paskins that if there's a Levana, the night of Purim, and they weren't Mechadish Levana yet, so you should go Bein Apra, come and go be Mechadish Levana, come back in. Now again, I'm not trying to say you should talk during Kriyas HaMegillah. You're not allowed to talk during Kriyas HaMegillah. But in terms of someone you have to hear the Megillah over again, it's not true you have to hear the Megillah over again if a person is talking. If a person taka misses out a word, so there's a problem. You have to hear again from that word onwards. Because you can't lay the Megillah Mafreya. But if a person doesn't know if he heard a word or not, if he's OCD, then he's not included to hear again. If he's not OCD, so he has a genuine suffix now. The person has a suffix. Did I hear a word or did I not hear a word? Or, so, if it's a suffix, she'ein eshakel, you could assume a person heard the word. But if it's a suffix eshakel, the equal chance, maybe I heard, maybe I didn't hear. So here's the plan, he goes back to the same thing that we said before. If it's by day, where the chiv is, a chiv medivir kabbalah, strong the chiv, you can actually hear it again. You can't make a brach on it. If it's by night, it could be mekel. And if it's a word that bechlal doesn't affect the meaning of the pasuk, there's another room to be mekel, because according to many pasuk, it's yotze even without that word. And if it's a woman, their chiv is a chetchila medivir rabbana both by day and by night. So if it's sure she can mekel, if she's mesupik, if she's sure she didn't hear a word, you got to read again from that word onwards. One more thing about Megillah, we'll move on. There's many other things we have to talk about. If a person misses out part of a word, so it depends. If it's a word that it changes the meaning and we miss out the end of the word, by the way, it's not only a shaila for Megillah. You have a question about Kiddush, you have a question about Abdullah. I'm out of Mekodesh. Hey. You made the word L'chol. Everybody starts saying Amen. You know in shuls when the chazan goes Baruch Hashem Kadesh Yisrael Vazman. The Amen was said way before on the Kadesh Yisrael V'yem Azikaron. Yeah. So there's some chazanim that are very makbin this, and they go Kadesh Yisrael Hazmanim. That's how they finish the bracha. So people shouldn't say Amen when before you finish. Al pi lach, you have to say Amen when you finish the bracha. But people miss out then. So if it's like a terrible thing, like there's nothing to be yotze there. There's kiddush nazal. It's a problem. So al pi din, if the word changes its meaning by you not hearing it, I'll give an example. Matanis lev yoinim, and you don't hear the mem of matanis lev yoinim. What does that sound like? Lev yoini.
That means my poor person. That's a different meaning. Levyonim means poor people.
Well, that's not a problem. But if he doesn't hear the noon of Haman, okay, it's the name Haman, we know it's Haman, you didn't hear the noon, okay, let's... So if the person starts having his OCD concern, maybe I did hear the noon, didn't hear the noon, lazar, so to say. Okay, let's move on I'll say one more thing about Megillah, move on to the halachas of the day. The Magen Avraham says that if somebody in the middle of Kriyas HaMegillah, the Baal Kodesh, starts getting stage fright, I don't know what happens to him, and he can't lean any further, someone else takes him over, the next person has to come and lean the Megillah from the beginning. Are they passing the Magen Avraham? Massive Chiddush. A lot of people have questions on the Magen Avraham. The Nafkamina is, I don't know if people get stage fright in the middle of Megillah, but in Gomer Tzai, you think it might be easier because you start, not finish. The arrangement will make. According to the Magen Avraham, this could be a shaila. The Magen Avraham only talks about if the guy is nishtatik, if he can't continue. He doesn't talk about if he planned to divide it like a chatchilah. Could be he would be makel about that, because this guy can't talk anymore literally. I mean, we just decided to divide it. So if there's a need from a tzayim for whatever reason, okay, there's enough room to be makel in a certain circle, which actually this was the minig. The minig was in certain chassidishah places. They had divided kriyas HaMegillah to different people. So there's definitely room to go along with that. And in fact, a very strong raya that the minig is not like the Magen Avraham is. If people miss out words in the Megillah, what do? They read themselves from the Chumash from Megillah. So how many people read the Megillah? Two people. And you have the Baal Kodesh, who is waiting till Pasuk Yud Zayin, and you're waiting Pasuk Yud Zayin, and then he's waiting from Pasuk Yud Chet. That's what happens when you miss out a word. So you clearly see that we're not keeping this Chumrah. You have to make some type of distinction. No, the Magen Avraham holds the Taka, not allowed to do that either. So if there's a Taka needed, dividing the Chumrah, to have two people in the Megillah, you can do that if you have to. Let's move on to the other mitzvah of the day. We said if we go and say the men, there's men from Mikra Megillah moving out to Matanis Levyonim. A question which I get every single year, including this year many times, which I never understand the question. I think it's even on the list of questions for tonight. What's the minimum for Matanis Levyonim? Nobody ever asked me what's the minimum for Shalach Manus. Why they ask what's the minimum for Matanis Levyonim? And what am I yoitza with? So today the person asked me this question, that I've come out of a chuppah, the person asked me this question, I asked him,
what's the minimum in the bifl is the minimum, he said.
Nei, ich will give a mention of mifzoim. I said, okay.
Finally I understand where you're coming from.
The Rambam paskins, mutav la'odim laharbois bin matanis le'evyoinim, but all these mitzvahs says laharbois. It's a mitzvah to laharbois besudas purim. The mitzvah, kol ha-marba l'shloich l'reyim ha-reizim m'shubach b'mashalach monos, and the mitzvah laharba is matanas levyonim. Which one is better to be marba? Zog the Rambam, in the end of Sefer Zman, Mendel Litz Megillah, better to be marba is matanas levyonim. So what does that mean in practical terms? I mean, there's many ways I understand the Rambam. The simple explanation is, how much is this pudum kosti? How much is shalach monos kosti? Good. Matanas levyonim should be more than that. And he sleeps on Olam Hafach, Shalach Manas. It's nothing with Shalach Manas. It has to do with cultural debt owing to people, whatever, all kind of theme characters, v'chul v'chul. That's what Shalach Manas has to do with. And Matanis Levyonim is like sort of, yeah, okay, there's a kupa, yeah, 5 cents, okay, each one. And so the question is a difficult question, some way people have that attitude. In some places they made a takana, and when Hagi Amsterdam they made a takana, you shouldn't send more than 3 minim to Shalach Manas. It just got out of hand. I wonder what they would do if they'd be around today.
They made a takana. Leu yaisim egim uminim.
The Rebbe sent to 3 people. The Pasha at the time where the Rebbe sent to 3 people is what he said in the Hanukkah also is. Because Alpidin only supposed to send to one. But it says the mitzvah be marve. So how do you show you being marve? Instead of sending to one, he sent to 3. 2 is just 1, it's just 3.
In fact, when it gave to an oval, it says he's supposed to send only to one person, and then some, to Manam Rotenberg, sent Lebezoi Gimel Anashim. Except it's Bezoi Gimel, because you want to do the union of being Marba, even for an oval, okay. Well, then be Marba, but not more than that. I'm not suggesting people should start insulting people and not sending them Shalach Manas. That's also a problem. But definitely the focus should be on Matanis Levyonim. So the minimum, yeah, the minimum is a pruta. And if you check the price of silver today, I didn't, but if you checked it, it's pretty low.
And I would guess I'm just throwing a guess over here based on last time I checked, it's probably less than 3 cents of pruta. Which is two of yoyim, each one, a nickel, should be matanas levyoyim. But the person that say he's supposed to give him enough money, he's supposed to be a matanah mechubedes. Nobody's on the way to give him a nickel. The person that say he should give him enough money to be able to buy a sudas purim. And then again, remember, we have the Rambam that says it's better to do that. Matzul shalach manas and sudas purim. So we definitely shouldn't look out to try to cut out matanas levyoyim. Besides for the fact that it says if purim is another din, it's brought a shulchan aruch. Not just the Chassidish Amini, which means in addition to Matanis Lev Yoyim, it's Lav Dafke Dinah Matanis Lev Yoyim, it's a Dinah in Dinah Simchas Purim. Not Matanis, Matanis Lev Yoyim you've done. Now there's another gather called Simchas Purim, Kala Pashid Yad, Eim Edakhtik Memoris Purim. You don't ask, yeah, Nish. And according to some Rishonim, Kala Pashid Yad means Afilu Goyim. Afilu that Pashid
is very good.
Huh? They know that there's a shame that they call Pesach Nizmi Divin Goyim. Even if they don't know, Mazlai Yechazi. So, call Pesach Yad, aim with that, we don't check. If somebody comes to town, he says, Halbishuni, Kasuni, Hachiluni, depends. For clothing, you check, for eating, not. There's none of these rules. Comes to my Spurim, you give people money. The Minig is also said to give to Malamdim, to Rabbanim, to Chazanim, to there's a Negi over here. To Shamashim is such a Minig that's brought on the Peskin. To Moistis, Eineyem Nesuas, Ludmei Purim, yeah, there's such a Minig. But that's not Matanis Levyonim. Unless they really are Avyonim. That's not Matanis Levyonim. Matanis Levyonim means taka someone who's taka Kipshuta in Avyon. And you're not supposed to give it for Meiser, the minimum that means you shouldn't be for Meiser. And you're supposed to give it for Shia. So many times you sit by Sudas Purim. And you just ask the question, try this. It's like asking an old Torah how many kids have led in the Sefer Torah. So try, and you sort of spit him and ask, who didn't give Matanis Lev Yoyim? Shalach Manas, they did. Yisra Megillah, they did. Mishta v'Simcha they're doing right now. What about Matanis Lev Yoyim? So basically, then watch Matanis Lev Yoyim, anyhow, be delayed till the end of the day. Nachashayel, the Rebbe right after Yisra Megillah, the Rebbe went, and what are checks Matanis Lev Yoyim? I mentioned before the Minchas Elazar, his minig was before Minchas Megillah, he did Matanis Lev Yoyim. Okay, maybe there's a Svara to do it after Megillah, because the Shechiyonah should go on Matanis Lev Yoyim. So why should he wait for it? So Mitzvah, first thing in the morning. Anyway, do after Kris. Davening, after Shachris, Matanis Lev Yoyim. Instead of waiting and say, oh, it's Shkia, it's not after Shkia. So what should I do right now? Okay, you don't make a bracha, it's okay. So you're not going to make a bracha in Matanis Lev Yoyim. You can do it till Sesek Chav, and you still, misafik, you might be Yitzhak, but why should you push on Matanis Lev Yoyim? Huh? Okay, so there are places that say that Evin means Aniyim Rudim Muflagim. Mamish, Mamish, people that have garnish, Evin is even less than Ani. I'll be then at Matkach Evin. Evin means someone doesn't have enough money to support his family, himself and his family. And there are a lot of people.
There's a party and there's no one around the table that's an Evin. Like,
no, so then you put it aside, like it says in Shulchan Aruch, you put it aside, which you could do that if you don't have an Evin. You can put it aside and put it into two pushkas, two cups, one for one and one for another. I mean, and I'll have to put it and give it out to them. It's better to give it to them on Purim. You can't. So you can do that. Sorry? You can do it online also. I mean, I don't know when they're giving it out online. Basically, if you want to have the advantage, some of them advertise they're giving it out on Purim, whether it's true or not true, and how much commission they take. Whatever. I'm not commenting about that, but most of these online Matanis Lev Yoyim, out of the money they're giving to Matanis Lev Yoyim, yeah, 5 cents. Shia Pruta is maybe going to get to the Evyon. But you have another people that are simply sitting in 7-7, they're Pashtav Yoyim Kipshuta. Enough money to support people. I know who has money to support the family nowadays. It's not hard to find. Yeah. I'd rather not take questions. I'll take just two questions and we'll move on. Yeah.
Could someone give away all this money, become Evyon, that everyone else,
only if he's from the litter, from some Snagisha circle, maybe he should do that, but not. Yeah, it's now they take a certain guy from before the Shoshana. You know, we take him and we put him aside and make sure he should stay in Evian all the way until Purim, so he should have my Evian. Hey, what's the man begging on my name from the Evian girl? It's a 9 Evian. Saved him.
Yeah. If you give money to a Moise, are you going to...
You're not yet Matanis Lev Yoyim, only to Aniyim. There is an Indian to give to Moises, there's such a minig. Like I said, there's a minig to give to people that do Avedis HaKadosh, to Malamdim, to Moises, there's such a minig. Eineyem Nesuis, it says they're looking forward to this money, but that's not Matanis Lev Yoyim. It's a good part of the Kol HaPayshid Yad. And let's hope that we come to a time when we have the shayla of what we'll do matanis l'vayim l'asad l'avi, because we'll be mekuyim efes k'riyeh b'chayevyeh, and we'll worry about it. I'm not going to say we'll worry about it then. Let's worry about it now. Next mitzvah, also important, equally important, because all mitzvahs are very important, we should spend more effort on, like we said, matanis l'vayim, l'shalach manis. So I mentioned before that it's people that do matanis l'shalach manis as a part of a cultural thing, and he's going to be insulted, and I gave him, and didn't give him, there's all this kind of stuff. There's an interesting chikiri in Peskin. There's a meaning that you give back shalach manas. It's such a meaning. It's not just coming from Bar Park to Crown Heights. It's actually brought down. There's rice from the Gemara for such a meaning. And there's a few svaras for the reason for the meaning. Where the meaning came from. But some want to argue that if you're giving back shalach manas to somebody, you're not going to get to shalach manas. It almost becomes like a chayv. You know, you have to give back, because that's in the Gemara we have a concept called with Rambam, Moses, Shulchan Aruch. Nowadays, it doesn't exist anymore. Called shushvinus. Shushvinus means that the meaning was that you come to my wedding and pay, and come, I have to come to your wedding, give a gift, you have to give back. It became so binding, this meaning, that you could go to a bezin and demand, one second, I came to his wedding, and that was part of the simcha, and I paid. Why shouldn't you pay for me? You could even demand an entreda. Some culturally binding customs become mandatory. So there's an argument that if you give back shalach manas to someone, could be not it's. And indeed, what's the idea of shalach manas? Lahar b'sreyes, to show friendships. You go to a person that you're not mechuyev. He didn't give me. I don't have to give him. I'm just giving because I want to give him. L'shem is giving. It's like a beautiful minig, but you should give shalach manas l'shem shalach manas. And you want to be Mekayim Minig HaAdmur, it says, Shevin Amas Ad HaYidah V'Rav, and of course, not an Aveda. You want to give to three people like that. Three people. You want to do Kohen Levi Yisrael like the Rebbe did, even though the Rebbe wasn't Mefarsim that he gave to Kohen Levi Yisrael, so for sure not HaYidah V'Rav. You want to do that. Also, not a bad idea to Kohen Levi Yisrael.
Can you get to a company? After the basket, or online,
to a
candy store?
Like I said, if you're talking about commission over there, I know a lot of the Shalach Manas.
Order online to
Shalach Manas. This doesn't make a difference who's being a shliach. You don't send any shliach. In fact, you don't need a shliach for Shalach Manas. You can send it directly, but the minig is to use a shliach, and the minig is to even use katanim and shluchim, even though normally katanim can be a shliach. So you want to call a company and have them do Shalach Manas, and they want to have 20 people you tell the Shalach Manas. However, half of these Shalach Manas are not food, so it's not Shalach Manas. But it has to be food, and food has to be your shalach manas. So 25 people are shipping in the shalach manas. Each one has to have two foods. So I don't know if that's going to happen or not happen. There's an easy way of doing shalach manas, just doing shalach manas. Let me talk about it. You know, it's just easy if I go through Al HaSeder. I said before that there's a minig that you give back shalach manas. I saw one explanation for this minig. That b'chlal we have a shayla if we say chazak shlich, I say shlichus.
How do you know
if you
gave it to him? By
deraisa,
we don't say
chazak
shlich
chayes shlichus. And since shalach manas kuvis midivrei kabbalas, it's like a deraisa, so maybe I can't rely that the shlich gave it to him.
That's where the minig is. He gives back shalach manas. I see the kid coming back with shalach manas. I know that shalach manas made a deal.
Agish makib shad. There's also a minig by shalach manas.
They don't say thank you for shalach manas.
The minig brought down from the Leket Yeshu. Leket Yeshu goes back to the time of the Trumas Hadesh before the Shulchan Aruch. The Ksav Yad was only printed recently, in the last few hundred years, but the author, it's on the time of the Trumas Hadesh,
if the Rebbe said about the Sefer,
that the Sefer says, Yachasit schreibt sein Nebis Menhagen. Er schreibt alles. That's what the Rebbe described the Sefer. So the Chasid of the Trumas Hadesh, rather than Walls Menhagen,
he wrote there that the minig was not to say thank you for Shalach Manas.
Why? It's a mitzvah, we don't say thank you. I don't know how you do that, but you get one of these fancy baskets, they don't say thank you. The only eitz I could say is, the minig is a mezaken shtadank.
That might be the only eitz.
What are you supposed to send? You're supposed to send two foods to one person. You don't have to send more than one person, unless you want to do, like I said, the minig of laharbis. Man to man, woman to woman. A family shalach manas is not you sending shalach manas. Each individual and each individual kid that have made a big hisoiris in the yuz and the chafs, that the mitzvahs of Purim are very easy mitzvahs to keep. Not making a megillah. Shalach manas and matanas levyonim, the Rebbe said, are very easy to keep. And even kids could do it. And even if there's something that they deal with, the Rebbe pushed it very, very strong. And the Rebbe gave practical examples. 2 pennies, a cookie, a candy, a couple of letters of the Rebbe. They were pushed very strong that kids should do shalach manas So we get our kids to come to shul to disturb us for Kriyas HaMegillah. We, our kids all have a list of all the kids in their class and have to send Shalach Manas to. But they also have to remember Matan Slav Yoinim. Part of the Chiyuchinov, again, that's something that they shouldn't forget. What's considered two foods? There's a big myth out there that two foods means two brachas. I have no idea who the first person that takes credit for this myth. But it's been around since I was a little kid, together with a bunch of other myths out there. There's no such thing, but there's such a thing about two different foods, is a machlokes. But even if it has to be two different foods, it doesn't have to be two different brachas. You can take an apple and an orange. That's perfectly fine. Two foods, yeah. And the Rabbein would send Meichel or Mashke. And the Rebbe would send two Macholim and one Mashke. So yeah, it's all the opinions, right? Side Rebbe send food and liquid, and side two foods. So the Rebbe would send two foods and a liquid. In Ovel, the minig is, we mentioned before, shouldn't send to a lot of people, and should only send simple food, not a fancy Shalach Manas. And Le'idach, we don't send to an Ovel Shalach Manas. You could send, a person can send to the family. The Ovel doesn't have to say, no, I'm not taking it. But the minig is the one that the Rebbe sent a message on Tavshin Chafei, the Rebbe sent a message to people to send to Shalach Manas. Next mitzvah, Sudas Purim, Mishta V'Simcha. Before we go to Mishta V'Simcha, there's Cloudy Yomtiv and Purim in the Megillah. It says one time it says the word Yomtiv. Mishnah says the Yomtiv Mishloach Manas. Another time it doesn't have the word Yomtiv. So it's interesting. One time it says Matan Sevyanim, one time it says Matan Sevyanim. And some Achrayim want to say that when it was made as a Yomtiv, they couldn't do Matan Sevyanim because they can't handle money on Yomtiv. But since it said the Gemara said they were made as a Yomtiv, but they were not, even were not Makabalit. Esther tried to push the Yomtiv agenda. Didn't go through. So once it became Ois Yomtiv, we could do Matan Slav Yoinim. That's a nice chap, no place like that. Alpidin Purim is not Yomtiv. Even though I heard from a person that for a fact that told me that I trust him that he was by the Rebbe and Purim, and the Rebbe told him it's Yomtiv. So it's Shailas, it is a Yomtiv on some level. The meaning is that we cheat like a Yomtiv, it's not bad to me Yomtiv. Al Derech, we say good Yomtiv, not seeing Kippur, it's Elisha Chalala, we didn't say good Yomtiv. So people should remember to make him to a Yomtiv and have a meal, not seeing Kippur. Not to eat, not a meal. We're gonna remember. So Purim is some level of a yamtiv. Lamash ben gave to Malacha. So Alpi din Purim is not us the basis Malacha, because we were not makabel yamtiv. But the minig became not do Malacha, and the minig is a binding minig. And so much so that it says the person does Malacha on Purim, he doesn't see a sima bracha, whatever that means. So, like Alpi described, not seeing sima bracha, that whatever he's making off that Malacha is going to lose from somewhere else. So, you're not... Okay, so I'm going to describe. The definition of Malacha here is less than Chalamoid. Now, it's hard to tell people less than Chalamoid because nobody knows anymore that is Isra Malacha and Chalamoid. According to many Rishonim and Raisa, that's something that needs a lot of education. And that, like someone once said cleverly,
that in the time when he came to America, originally was Shemitah Shabbos. He couldn't have a job, he didn't teach. Kept Shabbos. That was the Messiah when he came to America. Now with Baruch Hashem progressed, now the Messiah is Shemitah's Chalamoid.
First, we close the store on Chalamoid, this is a bit. But yeah, there's something called Chalamoid. This is less than Chalamoid. The definition of Malacha means Malacha that takes time. It's not the same as Lamatas Malachas, it means something which is a 1, 2, 3, you let it turn on the light. You let it go into your car. Like I said, it's like Chalamoid in that sense. But even when you're doing small Malachas, you have to always remember not to be distracted from Simchas Purim. If it's a malacha, which is L'tzorech Purim, L'tzorech Simchas Purim,
for sure you'll have to do on Purim. Whenever you talk to people about the malacha Purim, what's the malacha they think of right away? I'm allowed to take a haircut, I'm allowed to do laundry. But the evidence is that laundry and haircut are actually not considered malachas.
Even Chalamoid, the reason you're not allowed to take a haircut on Chalamoid, or do laundry, because they want to encourage people to take a haircut. Min Adin, you would be able to take a haircut on Chalamoid, because it's not considered a malacha haircut. Min Adin, you'd be able to do laundry on Chalamoid. It's not considered a malacha. But Chazal didn't want a person to come into Yom Tov Shuhum Anuvel, mit Lan Gehar. So they made a rule, you can't take a haircut on Chalamoid, so you're stuck. You can have to take before Yom Tov. So then people come to you and they say, I pushed them to take before Yom Tov. Can I take now Chalamoid? That was the reason why they made this rule. And the same with laundry. They didn't want a person to come into Yom Tov not with properly nice, beautiful clothing. So they made a rule, you can't wash clothing in Chalamoid. But it's be'etzim, not a malacha. So Mela, when it comes taka to Purim, it's not a malacha. Of course, the person's allowed to Definitely in a washing machine, there's no problem to do laundry. Haircut is l'soyrich purim, it's a simcha for purim. He's allowed to do that. Business is not called malach in this context. Person is allowed to do business. And the lashon is things that make money, simcha hiloy. Actually, simcha for the person. Yizor shalo yimshich ba v'yizbatl m'simchas purim. You're going to get carried away with your online business. And you're going to forget about simchas purim, so don't get carried away with it. But yeah, I'll think that's okay. Part of the, what we do have it, that's the Yom Tov and Purim, min adin is Mishra Simcha, which means a person is not allowed to fast on Purim. Hesped v'tayinis, now I'll give a Hesped on Purim. And also there's a mitzvah of eating a Simcha's Purim. And the Simcha is even greater than Simcha's Yom Tov. What does that mean, Sudas Purim? So by night is a minik to have a meal by night, but it's not a chiv al pidin, it's a minik brought on a Shulchan Aruch. Have a meal. Some places the minig is dafka not in place. You play a purim to show that it's not really, you're not yours to do the purim, so they don't explain it's not a purim. But there's such a minig, Toiv Lev Mishra Tamid, but the chiyav of Sudas Purim is by day. And our minig, the Ramar brings us minig that we start the meal by day, we continue it into the night. We have an early mincha, and then we start the meal closer towards the end of the day. You're allowed to do the meal in the morning. Some people are makbid dafka do in the morning. They're afraid they're going to, who knows what's going to happen to them. They want to be eating in the morning. But al pidin, and the hour meal is to do it towards the end of the day. Most of the meal should be by day. Whatever most of the meal means, it's nishalei pashu, what that means, most of the meal means most in terms of time. Right, you're allowed to go on for hours and hours. I mean, most of the menu should be done by day. But certainly you should make sure, if you want to do properly the way the halacha should be, we're makbid, even though it's al pidin lav dafka, we're makbid to wash. Be considered a Suda, Suda's Purim, or makbid to eat meat, and to drink wine. Those three things you should do by day. And then you could carry on against the nachas. In regard to drinking tafel, and some the krepelich and the hamatash are good idea to have by day, although it's not makbid if you had it by day or by night. In regard to drinking, ask something quick. So this is a question everybody asks. What's drinking? You're allowed to drink, you have to drink, you're not allowed to drink. What's the gather of drinking Purim? So, the Bekaber says in Shulchan Aruch, the Dinu Shulchan Aruch, Chai Dinu Shul Sunu, the Purya, Ad Liyadu, Benar, Hamul Baruch Martin. That's the beginning and end of the Shulchan Aruch. In the Chuyub, Pasha Tait Shulchan Aruch, there's a big mahalaj of how to translate those words. In the Chuyub, to drink on Purim until you know the difference between Ar Hamul Baruch Martin. Bekaber was a bit unfair over here. I'm allowed to say that. Because in the Bis Yosef, he wrote a whole machlokes, how he determined those words. Does it mean man to become shikha? No, it doesn't mean to become shikha. It means, come to Shulchan Aruch, left everything, I just wrote the halach and didn't explain what he means. The Rama, and we Ashkenazim, we follow the Rama, says, Yesh oimim ein tzarech l'shtaka kol kach. But before you even go further, l'shtaka kol kach means you're supposed to get drunk, but not kol kach. Yesh oimim, you have to get kol kach. But then he adds, Rak, what should you do? Sheyishte yoysim ilimudai, which some people erroneously think mean drink more than you learn. So you don't have to drink a lot. Yishte yoysim ilimudai means drink more than you normally drink. Memele, you'll fall asleep. And you'll fall asleep, he won't know the Bizarre Hamel Baruch Martin. That is the halakha. We, B'nai Yisrael, yoysim yad rabah, al pi din, yoysim ad layada. What you're supposed to be doing is you drink a bit more than normal, you feel a bit more upbeat. He feels it's you drank more than normal, whatever. Drank a bit extra. And he falls asleep. Now, Chassidim are not looking for some cop out. I'll be yoitz according to the Ramah, I'm already yoitz. I want to do the mitzvah chatchila. There's a lot of days that all adle adam means kipshute. But it's a bit risky to do the mitzvah kipshute on a number of levels. I remember the Rebbe once commented, I was seeing when the Rebbe said it, Zetos is high yon in Brooklyn, not in the Kangan Adli Adad Ruch Shlofen. It appears that in Brooklyn this year they did Adli Adad through sleeping. They did the Misnagdish version of Adli Adad. So I'll be doing, yeah, there's definitely room to be Mahadar, but there's exceptions. There's some people that are putter from drinking or are not allowed to drink. Doesn't include sounds. Women are patur from the mitzvah of Adliyada. Children are patur from this mitzvah. I know the Gra is into the children to drink wine on Purim, but they're part of the mitzvah. Bachrim, well, any Bachrim, the Rebbe many times spoke against Adeliyah by Bachrim. And not only that, the Rebbe spoke about people that are under 40, also that is Gzeir on Purim. Now there's a whole Torah luction that floats around every year. Purim comes out that the Rebbe one year said this and one year said like that. It's totally inaccurate, to put it mildly. Because the Rebbe never said that the Gezeira doesn't apply on Purim except for once, the year that he made the Gezeira. And listen to what he said. So the raya that people bring is because the Rebbe once said, Mzalmakam Zanav Le'ad Kepshutai. And Tavshim Em Tes, I remember when the Rebbe said it. On Psharis, on Hetayrim, Zhuav Le'ad Kepshutai. So the Rebbe didn't specify, I wasn't talking about Bachrim. Why did he have to specify that? He was talking Bechlal. The Gzeira he never made. The Rebbe didn't say, Ichnemer of the Gzeira. There were certain times the Rebbe said he's taking off the Gzeira. There was, I remember right now, at least three times the Rebbe said once by Fabreng and Shabbos Bereishis Tavshei Chafes. Look for the Rashi Sikha of today, he's taking off the Gzeira. The Rebbe is taking off the Gzeira. He said that people should Mekayim. He's talking to the people that are supposed to be Mekayim. The one time, the first time the Rebbe made the Gzeira was Tavshei Chaf Gimel, and the Rebbe said then that this applies all the time except for Purim. I'm not mixing it for two reasons. One, because by the time Purim comes, this is Parsha Shmini. This Purim is like a full year afterwards. Moshiach will already be here. And the second reason is because Purim is supposed to be the Matzah of Adliyada. If this person is the Matzah of Adliyada, he wouldn't even think about bringing Moshiach. What did Rebbe say? Adliyada, what Rebbe meant over here? Beruch Nisim Yanam. He wouldn't even think. That's what the Rebbe said. Later, the Rebbe, when the Rebbe started pushing the Gzeira, this is the first time. The Rebbe said the Gzeira, Sai Purim, Sai Sufasteira, Yubis Tams Chafei, a bunch of times the Rebbe said that. So the Rebbe Gzeira, this is a double pashat by me, and I've seen the literature otherwise, Sasichat and Gimel Slichas, and not one of them, the Rebbe is being Messiachas, so the Gzeira is being Messiachas, the Shachanah. The Rebbe Gzeira of Mashka applies and Purim as a double pashat. Of course, people are looking for a hetah for the Rebbe Gzeira. I wonder why they're looking back. The other people that are potter from the midst of Adliyada, the people that it's not healthy for them, either dangerous or even not healthy. If they're not healthy, if it's not healthy for them to drink, they're potter from Adliyada. Then there's Pais Convention, or somebody that as a result of Simchas Purim is going to accompany Mezalzel Beis and Mitzvah. For example, he's going to miss out benching, he's going to miss out Maidu, it's a Krishna. Then he's also potter from drinking. Now he's potter, then he shouldn't drink. The drink is not there to take away. Now, people know themselves if they're capable or not capable. Some people are capable of drinking, and drinking a lot. Kemat adliyada also. And still, they'll make sure to bench, they'll make sure to all other mitzvahs, because some things I'll never forget. Yeah, the shaila is, do you say, it's a mitzvah, patam, and a mitzvah? Since he's always a mitzvah adliyada, and he started the heter. No, so now I'm drinking. Later, it's going to happen later. But it looks like the person didn't take that argument. The other time when they say a person shouldn't drink, if he knows it, because that's going to cause an aveda miram lachaveda. He's going to be mavayir someone else. He's going to be mazik someone else. Okay, it's not so simple, because if a person is mazik someone else on Purim, there might be shtikl heter. It says if a person is mazik someone else mitzat simchas Purim, could be spotter from paying. The Rebbe, however, once spoke about this, and the Rebbe said that some people have abused this halacha. Sighed if you used it out before Purim or so. They said that because it says imagine if Simchas Purim, that means that they're allowed to be part of Kachanoshim, Shakronim, Kavim Lashon Hara, Litzonim, Chas V'Shom, I mean, Lashon Rebbe uses a very sharp Lashon, and none of those things take away the fall out of the way, because it didn't not being that if a person is Mazik, the halacha being Mazik, the Simchas Purim is a bit the Evid the Gedin. A person that wasn't a Simchas Purim, and it wasn't because he wanted to be Mazik, the other person was talking about Simchas Purim. And he was mazik, then it's a machlokes if he has to pay or not. So we'll take him to the Torah, and in the Bezdin he'll bring a toyin, and the toyin will say, one second, Allah mazik simchas purim. And the other toyin will bring the Yamsha Shloim that says that nowadays nobody's doing it because of simchas purim. And they'll fight it out. Fine. That's in dinei b'dieved, that's not a dinei l'chatchila. No, simchas purim, meg, no, let's go.
So, the Rebbe once spoke with him strongly about this. Memela, if somebody knows that they drink, this is what happens when they drink. And for some reason that's their soid, the taka shouldn't be drinking, then Adliyada doesn't apply over there. Interesting that the Rebbe had a mini every single Fabrengen, almost every single Fabrengen. What was the regular announcement the Rebbe always made? The Yalla daf machin abracha achreina, stam zikha machin abracha achreina. The Rebbe was like the Gabin Shul, right?
They have to make announcements about Bracha Chayim. It's like the Rebbe's job. The Rebbe decided, took upon himself a job. I don't think any of the Rebbeim did it. I don't know any Rosh Hashiva, Rebbe, Rav in the world that does it. The Rebbe took on. And the Rebbe said, where did he get it from? From the Ramah. What did the Ramah do on Purim? There's like about 5-6 fabrics where the Rebbe spoke about this Ramah. The Ramah on Purim would dress up and go to people's houses. He was the Rav in Shtat. And he would remind people to go daven Ma'ariv. Ma'ariv is Manah. Because he was worried what's going to happen on Purim. So the Rebbe said he took from the Ramah the idea to remind people to make a Bracha Chayim. So it's important with all the Simchas Purim, which Takas should be Adli, Yadeh, Blivul, not to forget the obligations, the regular obligations that we have, including Mitzvah Ma'ariv is Manah, which, like we said earlier, means you have to say Krishna at least before Chatzos. Okay, they changed the clock, so it's 1:05. By then you should be saying Krishna. Yeah.
You have the daven while the person's drunk.
Oh, so there's a whole set of halachas about that. Al pidin depends if he's yochel lam b'fnei melech or ain't yochel lam b'fnei melech. So there's a shasi and a shikr, and then a shikrus yishaloi. Shikrus yishaloi pam should not know what he's doing. If a person is so, if a person is in a stage that is ain't yochel lam b'fnei melech, and I'll tell you what that means kipshute. That I don't know anybody who's adli yad kipshute, but I've never met him yet. Looks like the mask over here is not good quality. But any other one, it'll be very simple. The Rebbe passes by, and he'll start hacking and trying to run the Rebbe. If that's the kind of shikas he has, then tfilosu tve eva o ke'ilu oive da vedezara. And he has to daven again. He has to daven again, obviously not then. When he's, if he's so shik, he's going to daven again and again and again anyhow. We're talking about kshiyasu yeyden in olam. Huh? Yeah, but then you run into a problem on this. But what's that, baby? You lighted that bench and do what the Rebbe did. What did the Rebbe do? The Rebbe had a studio earlier, finished. The Rebbe spoke about this more than once. The Rebbe spoke many times. Why do we have a Fabrega and Matze Purim at 9:30? Purim's over. What's the point? So the Rebbe said, an Adliyadad is Madrigus. So mainly, even though we reach one level of Adliyadad, now we can reach a high level of Adliyadad. And he didn't mean Adliyadad Shikus. Because by the Rebbe's Fabrega, B'derech Klal, most people are interested in hearing what the Rebbe says, not what they have to say. Unless they were one of the people that volunteered. Because one time the Rebbe asked himself to volunteer after the other, a certain individual volunteered, and there was one unhappy that he volunteered. He's not the Rebbe expressed himself a bit about it. But at the point of it, the Rebbe was asking himself, I'll be nice, I'll help the Rebbe out, I'll volunteer. So the Rebbe finished early, very early, and it came down. And it came down 9:30, when some, in the earliest was 9 o'clock. And I was like, why can't you daven might have finished a meal and daven might have? Yeah, if you daven might have more than a meal, then you have a problem with all this. It's better not to do that. So, the Rebbe spoke about this once about the Tzach Shalach Manas. You know, I'll stop right now for questions anyhow, because we can daven might have soon. Anyhow, talking about might have, what time is it now? Yeah, we have a few minutes and I will take questions now. I'm pretty much finished what I was going to say. Then he gave you a question. The Rebbe spoke, Sikha, about that, I think it was Tzach. Some organization prepared Shalach Manas, and the Rebbe complained that the Shalach Manas were not okay out to did. Because each Shalach Manas has to be at least a Kazayis, the Rebbe said, or the Chalapar is both together Kazayis. He didn't say anything about if it's drink, if it should be a Revis, the Rebbe didn't say that. Mistar Balaim al Khair, if it's food, it's a Kazayis, and if it's drink, it should be a Revis. Maybe the both, the Rebbe didn't say that. But apparently, that's Pashas. I can tell you the Rebbe said that they should each one be a Kazayis, or the Chalapar is both. Now, there are places that say it should be more than that. And the Rebbe Bukhari was talking just about the bare minimum, but at least it should be a Kazayis.
And two drinks.
Yeah, you are going to two drinks again. The minig is either Michael or Mashko, if you want to do what the Rebbe is. To do two machalam and a mashka, because some people say you're not here to the drinks. Well, if you didn't, you are here to the drinks.
Is anyone besides Aruch HaShulchan who holds two drinks yet? Is anyone besides Aruch HaShulchan who mentions two drinks?
The Gemara mentions it, what do you mean?
Two drinks, is it talking
about? The Gemara mentions one drink, what's the difference? If one drink is good and two is also good, what's the difference? The Gemara mentions drinks and Sefer Menhagim mentions drinks. So now, if we yoytu one, why should you be yoytu with two? So I said before, and if you were here before, that you're supposed to, chetchili should have roiv asuda b'yoyim, at least the key components of the meal, which is the bread, the meat, and the wine, should have before shkiyah.
I'm not going to say no. The truth is,
it's almost impossible not to be Yotze Sudas Purim. Let's say a person ate Sudas Purim and he threw up the whole thing. And let's say we follow the opinion that you're not Yotze to throw up. But he didn't eat anything else throughout the day. You're not Mechuyev to have pas for Sudas Purim. That's why if you don't say Alanis, you're off the bench again. L'chitchili should have pas, l'chitchili should have basi, should have basi behema, all night, krepelich and wine and everything. But to be Yotze Sudas Purim, what do you mean? He ate. He didn't eat anything throughout the day, he didn't eat a hamatash throughout the day. So yeah, if you want to do the way it should be, yeah, you should wash before Shkia and Achil the Reyes. There's a machlokes about that, and there's like some misconception out there that since we're Lubavitch Achsidim, for us it means mashka, not wine, but the Rebbe said a few times, there's a lot of rice that it means wine. Rashi says in the Gemara, L'Bsumel Ishtakir, B'yayin. But for Rashi, there's no rai, because he's mentioning Yayin as an example. It could be other mashkois. But the Rebbe mentioned Beferish by Fabrengen, the Shittim of the Rebbe Fabrengen, and the Rebbe said Beferish, Alamates, Fabrengen, they should say Lechai Dafka wine. So definitely should be mahadab to do Dafka wine. And then after you had your wine, you could drink as much other mashka, and you could even mix the two together also if you'd like to let's.
But you don't give it to that person that day. You put it aside. You ate it.
You are right, I mentioned before, that says if a person, the Makam She'en Anim Mitzuyim, so they didn't in Shulchan Aruch, in the grace of Shulchan Aruch. Makam She'en Anim Mitzuyim, she put it aside. I mean, it's active, and then I can get it later.
Is there a
market
for the merit of being, we have a shliach to be beyond the other?
The Alpidin? In Shulchan Aruch, I know there's your clue. So there's a Yid that wrote, a Yid that wrote to the Rebbe this question. A Rav wrote to the Rebbe, where did the Rebbe get this from, that he sent him making a shliach to do Adli Yadah? And the Rav finally wrote that he found up some makar, and the makar is from, I think it was Kiddush, the Vigdara Tafati, one of the Rishonim from the Sagada were printed. They bring such a meal that one person would drink it. So the Rebbe said he never meant to be Moisi. Kipshute. He meant, it's a long letter, that's one of the answers the Rebbe gave. He meant that B'derech Lav, one person's Adliyada, he makes the whole place happy. He didn't mean the Adliyada in the sense Yoitza. And then the Rebbe said, Hada Chkida B'chlau. There's a dinner, Mitzvah Shibagufa, Shlich, it doesn't help. Okay, but what if a person can do the Mitzvah Shibagufa? Is there a mile in a Shlich doing it? And then I left with that question. You have a chakira? Mr. Shabagufa, your shliach doesn't help. You need to do it yourself. What if a person can't do Mr. Shabagufa? Is there any plus in getting a shliach? So the Rebbe doesn't bring that in that letter, but it's interesting because Rebbe Aaron Belzer had a very interesting minig that he didn't sleep in the sukkah. So he said a shliach to sleep in the sukkah for him. So maybe he held, like the Rebbe says here in this letter, that at least a person can, at least let someone else do it. But the Rebbe said he doesn't mean shlichus in the regular sense of the word.
You could say Shema.
You don't have to say Shema Nesu before Chatzos. Shema has to be before Chatzos. Do you want to be Machmud even Ma'ir? Okay, it's definitely better to bench. What's the inner to continue? Because you want to have the inner of continuing the whole night.
I'm saying, is there an inner to say Shema with
the Ma'ir? There's an inner to say Krishna Berchusei every day. Every single day, every morning, which nobody does. Al Pidin, you're supposed to say Krishna Berchusei Bezmana. Right, that's what it says on Shulchan Aruch. And by Netzachama also, before Netz. But, so that same thing applies for sure for Ma'ariv. And we actually do that every single night for Ma'ariv. We daven Bezmana, right? We don't do like people that they daven Ma'ariv early and they say Krishna again later. Because we want to daven Ma'ariv Bezmana. So the same Bezmana goes for beginning of, like, early Shabbos. We don't want to do early Shabbos because we want to say Krishna. We want to daven Ma'ariv Bezmana. So the same thing applies to the end Zman, which better do Krishna Berchus says. Definitely better. Are you mechuyev to? No, you're only mechuyev to say Shema. But like I said, what would be the advantage of not stopping the meal, daven ma'ariv? The only chesed is you're afraid that Fabreng will fall apart. No, to be doichin Fabreng, and Fabreng is doichin everything. Almost everything. There's a famous bar from Ksin, there's certain things you don't do by Fabreng, you don't bench with the mezumim, you don't make a bracha chrei on your spot. None of the things means kipshutai. What it means is, you have to be careful not to disturb a chesed from Fabreng. So, you want to be machmir, you try to do it in a way that doesn't disturb.
What bracha do you say if you're Megillah for a woman who didn't hear yet and you heard already?
The Shmaya.
The Shmaya Megillah?
Shmaya Megillah. Or the Shmaya Mikra Megillah for the woman. Any other questions?
You say it or she said
it. If she could say it, better she should say it.
Say bracha.
The
Shmaya Megillah.
Shmaya Megillah.
Why would they
do
Megillah
just
for kids?
The Gilah or the Gilah? Gilah. Let them make it up. But you gotta find a kid that's a Gila Chinna means you can hear the whole Megillah. Even 13-year-olds have a hard time with that.
I'm
Moshe the kid spoke to two different aniyim, so he gave it. He gave him one pushkilos, you know. Kol chabad, he spoke to two different aniyim.
But you don't know if your money will go to two different aniyim. Shaki say yes, breira, and breira.
You can't sell an asset to two different aniyim.
If they can actually take the money and give it to one ani, how do you know? But if a fellow will be split into two ani, so it's no problem.
How do you know this? They're knocking that little nickel that you put in the push
pit. You should really give the two then.
What if you get a check and the check is not cashed?
You get it, say that's no problem.
Yeah,
you have to make the check. Fine, okay, we'll have the mitre.
Что ты пытаешься?